Hi, I'm Maddie, and this is our Frasca flight simulator modeled after a Cessna 172. In this video, we're going to talk about some advantages of having a flight simulator and how it's a great teaching tool to benefit flights and your training as a whole. Let's get started. So why is it good to have flight sims? We have the ability to pause flights and talk about something that needs to be improved without the time restraints of being in a plane, since lots of things need to happen simultaneously. That way, we can take our time. We can place the virtual flight anywhere in the world. We can simulate emergencies to better reflect real life. We can simulate engine failures and train the student on what to do, including finding a safe landing spot that we would be unable to replicate to such a degree in a cockpit situation. We can target a part of the student's training and as a result save them flight time. For example, if the student wants to perfect holding procedures, we can manipulate the environment to focus on their weaknesses, like wind correction angles. We can simulate poor weather situations that we wouldn't be able to replicate in a training environment. An example would be, during instrument training, we can show the student what it looks like to actually fly an approach at the lowest allowable weather minimums.
Sometimes people experience motion sickness while using the simulator. The reason for this is that our eyes are seeing movement, but our inner ear isn't sensing the movement. That disagreement causes nausea. But luckily, you can train out of that. It's easier to get over motion sickness on the ground rather than in a plane. We have the option to complete 40% of our instrument hours in a simulator because it is so closely modeled after an airplane. The FAA counts it as flight time. So with this cockpit layout, we have the capability of having the instructor sit next to the student, and we can then teach that way, how we would simulate teaching exactly in a plane. This is the instructor's control tower, where we control everything about the environment. Let me show you.
This is how we are able to reduce the visibility at any airport we choose. To simulate our emergencies mentioned before, we hit the total engine failure button, worst case scenario in real life. In low visibility conditions, it is now essential to use airport lights. We are able to control brightness and which ones we want to turn on. Circuit breakers can be tripped by the instructor and then reset by the student in the cockpit. Traffic awareness is emphasized when we use this feature.
This simulator is modeled after a technologically advanced aircraft, a kind of aircraft most airlines use. So once students make that transition, it's easier to interact with the equipment. That's it for this video. If you liked it, be sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe. Thanks for watching. See you next time.